from Casually Fragrant. Today I'll be doing a perfume haul. All of these finds are from Shoppers Drug Mart, which is basically the Canadian equivalent to Walgreens in the States. And all of these perfumes were $19.99 each in Canadian. They were all blind buys as well. Unfortunately, they don't have testers for their clearance discount rack. So the first fragrance I picked up was CK Into You. I have not purchased any CK fragrances for a while. I used to be obsessed with a lot of them, and now I just don't, haven't gravitated towards any of them. And when I saw this for $19, I just couldn't resist. It is released from 2007, a fresh floral oriental with some woodsy notes. It's got cactus in it, which I think makes it smell a little unique. Yes, I couldn't wait. I did open these up and spray them once. I did kind of want to have a bit of an idea of what it was that I was getting. If you want me to do a more in-depth review, like longevity, sillage, or anything else like that, and more in-depth with the notes, let me know and I'll happily do that for you. This here I will be definitely wearing in the summertime. I think it's for a warmer weather. The next scent I picked up is by Bvlgari. It's only the 25 mil, but it's the Omnia Amethyst one. I don't have any Bvlgaris. Oops, it does come beautifully packaged, if I can open it properly. And it isn't the kind of coiled perfume bottle. Instead, it's the kind of smaller one. I do think these are really cute. I have an obsession with purple bottles, purple florals. That's what I gravitate towards. When I saw this, I picked it up. It's released from 2006, woody floral. It's got heliotrope, iris, some green notes. It's a powdery scent. To me, this is a little sweeter than the new Marc Jacobs Daisy Twinkle. I do like this, but it is a little powdery, a little too powdery for me, which sometimes I like, but it's just not sweet enough violet type of heliotrope. I'm glad that I have this in my collection. Moving to the next Bvlgari I picked up was the another Omnia Paraiba. I have no idea how to pronounce this, but this is a semi-precious Brazilian stone. And this is as well a 25 mil. This is a tropical vacation in a bottle. This has notes of gardenia, passion fruit, vetiver, cocoa, orange. It's an exotic fruity floral. I prefer this one to the Amethyst, actually. And since this was released in 2015, it is a newer scent. And I really like this one. I will be wearing this as well in the warmer weather. I think there's a bit of a trend in some of the perfumes I picked up that they'll be in warmer weather. The next one I picked up is Couture Couture by Juicy Couture. I don't actually have any Juicy Coutures in my collection, so I was really tempted to pick one of these up, and of course I can't take it out of the box because it's got these weird packaging to it. But I did kind of take everything out. It does come with kind of this ribbon and this lid. This lid is, it's kind of cheap and flimsy. It's plastic, it's not heavy, it's not metal. This fragrance, it's a nice, you know, kind of fruity floral. It's actually oriental floral. It was released in 2009. I do think it's kind of an original concept with this ribbon here, but I kind of have a pet peeve of like really cheap light caps. And there is orange blossom in this, and I can kind of smell it. I'm not the biggest fan when it's done heavier. This is probably going to be passed on to a friend or a family member. I was really hoping to have a Juicy Couture in my collection, but this just isn't one of the bottles that I think I'll be wanting to keep. Moving to the fifth one I got was a Roberto Cavalli Eau de Parfum. This was released in 2012. It's a Eau de Parfum, and it's got intense oriental floral. And this, I mean, contrasting, this is a weightier metal cap. Definitely seems of better quality. It's got the little kind of like animal print here. I think the bottle is It's got some weight to it. I think it is a lot nicer. It's an intense kind of scent. It's got tonka bean in it and vanilla. And to me, this is a going out fragrance, definitely an evening scent, but I think it could be worn year round. Looking forward to giving this more of a chance. And lastly, I picked up a Nicki Minaj, and this is the Onika fragrance. Onika was released in 2014. And let's see if I can pull this in front. And it's the iconic female bust. This fragrance, it's got pear in it, starfruit, water lily, orchid, some mandarin orange. It's a sweet fruity floral. To be honest, I just wanted one of these Nicki Minaj scents. I do have a couple celebrity perfumes in my collection. I find that I gravitate towards celebrity perfumes that have, you know, something unique to the bottle, because the scents I find don't usually last the longest. I will be trying this one out, but so I'll let you know. Let me know if you want me to do a review of any of these scents. Let me know if you actually picked up any of these, or if you ever shop at Shoppers Drug Mart and you get some crazy deals on some perfumes. I'd love to know which ones you picked up. I post new videos every week, so if you enjoy watching perfume review and hauls, please subscribe. Thank you.